Detroit, Michigan, proud of its hockey past and its present, wanting a parade, and it hosts a Game 7. Sidney Crosby, Pittsburgh Penguins captain, if his team wins, he gets to hold the Stanley Cup first. Former Penguin Marian Hossa with Detroit felt he could win a championship sooner here. Maybe. We'll see. Game 7, Penguins and Red Wings, the Stanley Cup Final on NBC. Seven, a wonderful yet desperate time in sports. Tuesday night, the Penguins were on the edge of another hometown Game 6 elimination. But a young goalie turned away repeat disaster. Getting a piece of it was Fleury! Rapidly maturing, the young Penguins won. Now they must battle the history of Hockey Town and the pride of a franchise with a captain well accustomed to victory.
Pittsburgh Penguins select.
Hope is to be found in a former prodigy.
Sidney Crosby.
Especially as his rapid progression and determination has called to mind more than ever a champion of Pittsburgh past. Tonight, two great traditions, the raising of the Stanley Cup and the ultimate desperation on ice. Legacies are at stake. Game 7, next. What a goal! It's my one score! Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. The Stanley Cup is not here yet. It will be fashionably late, but it will be presented. NBC is proud to present Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Final, the Penguins and the Red Wings. Good evening, everyone. I'm Mike Emmerich. What a wonderful experience lies ahead, a Game 7 of a Stanley Cup Final. Many of the hockey athletes you'll see tonight began playing at age 4 or 5. And as kids, they would pretend, Stanley Cup Final, Game 7, the puck's on my stick. No pretending tonight. They are gathered in locker rooms. The coaches have had their words with them. What have they said? Well, it's privileged information. We don't know. But we have some ex-coaches who think they do. Pittsburgh Penguins locker room, Pierre McGuire. Detroit Red Wings locker room, Mike Milbury.
Men, words don't win Game 7s. Actions do. Your actions have gotten you to this Game 7 opportunity. You've been spectacular through every round of the playoffs and through the practices and through the regular season. This is our opportunity. You represent an amazing legacy. You wear the same sweater as the teams that won Stanley Cups in 1991 and 1992. This is your moment. This may not be our rink, but this is our room. We walk together, we go to the ice together, we win together. When this night is over, we bring the Stanley Cup back to our great fans.
Listen, we've worked all year, 8 months to get here, for the privilege to work one more day to prove that you can be the very best in the world at what you do. It's a privilege. It's not a burden. There shouldn't be any pressure. Pressure, hell, we know what pressure is. Pressure is the people here that lost their jobs. And those are the people that you represent today. And all I want from you today is one last day of effort, one last day of work. And if you give me that, you'll give yourselves and your teammates in this city a legacy that will last more than a lifetime.
Another former coach, Eddie Olczyk, has joined me here. What about Game 7s in general and this one in particular?
Well, I want to put on my game sweater.
I know.
After hearing Mike Milbury, I mean, that's how intense and what an opportunity, Doc. I mean, this is an opportunity of a lifetime for both of these teams. If you think it's right, you do it. And I'm going to zero in on the goaltenders, the most important position tonight, I believe, for both teams. Marc-Andre Fleury pulled in Game 5 after giving up 5 goals. But boy, oh boy, did he bounce back in a great way in Game 6. 25 saves. I thought he was confident. I thought he was in control. And that's the one thing I'm going to look to, Doc. And back in Game 6, that great save against Daniel Fleury, making sure he does not lose his net. And the three-time Stanley Cup winner, Chris Osgood, in his career in the Stanley Cup Final, 11-5 record, including 3 shutouts. Positionally, he needs to be out on top of that goal line, out on top of that crease. And Doc, for both of these teams, this is it. This is an opportunity playing Game 7. There are 28 other teams in the National Hockey League who would love to be in this position. I'm excited about it, and let's get that puck on here tonight.
Well, that's right. More about goaltending from our goalie guru, Darren Pang.
Well, over my left shoulder will be Marc-Andre Fleury, the goalie for Pittsburgh. He has experience in Game 7 before. He'll have to go back to that well and do what he did against the Washington Capitals. Remember that. The crowd's going nuts. 20,000 people. He makes an unbelievable glove save on Ovechkin. That's the kind of action and activity that he's going to need here. He has not shown confidence, nor has he shown calmness right here at Joe Louis Arena. It will be essential if they're going to lift the Stanley Cup. Doc?
The dressing rooms have now filled up. The last team to win a pro sports title on the road in a seventh game was from Pittsburgh, the Pirates of 79 in Baltimore. Since then, home teams like the Red Wings have won 18 straight. Is tonight the exception or the rule? The teams take the ice in just a moment. No change in either lineup for Game 7 from Game 6. What will be tonight's lasting memory? Game 7s have long memories. The Red Wings are 11-1 on home ice this year, 20-3. The last two playoff years, trying to be the first to win in back-to-back years since they did it themselves in 97 and 98. And these Penguins are wearing T-shirts under these jerseys that say the pen's in your hand. Their coach, Dan Bylsma, has talked about writing the story themselves.
Coming back, Doc, as they did in Game 6, after getting blown out in Game 5. And the one thing that they've done, Doc, here in Detroit, even though they've lost all three games, is they've had good starts. And in that Game 5, they had a good start, missed an opportunity on a power play. Detroit's penalty kill was sensational. No shots on goal. And then Detroit took over from there. So look for another strong start by the Penguins in here in Game 7.
Can you remember a late game save by Mike Richter in 94, or Marty Brodeur in 2003, or Nikolai Habibulin in 2004, or Cam Ward in 2006, or Glenn Anderson scoring in 1987 late for Edmonton, all a part of Game 7's past? Pierre McGuire with Detroit captain Nick Lidstrom.
This has been a home ice series, Nick. What do you have to control in Game 7 so that you win your fourth game in the final?
You know, we have to pay attention to details, especially the little things that get the big puck in, get the puck out, and play strong defensively.
You know, when you think about your team, it's been 8 months of sweat and sacrifice to get here. What did you just say to your teammates before you came on the ice?
You know, this is a situation you want to be in. You want to be in a Game 7 and Stanley Cup Finals, and, you know, do the best of it.
Have fun, Nick.
He hopes at the end he'll get to lift 35 pounds of Stanley Cup's name on it already four times. We'll see. The opening faceoff is coming up from Detroit.
Fleury did everything the Penguins needed to get them to a critical Game 7.
Got one game to do something here, and coming off this game, he has a lot of reasons to be confident.
I don't feel pressure. I don't feel nervous. I love this time of year. I live for it.
Your goaltender has more of an ability to make an impact than any other player.
66. Every game in the series won by the home team. A pro Red Wing stat. 12-2 and 6 straight for the home team in Game 7. For the next few hours, seems to me like it's easier to be a fan of some other team than these two. Too much tension, too much of your heart involved. Sidney Crosby's line starts. That means Henrik Zetterberg and Pavel Datsyuk are out against him. Bill Guerin and Chris Kunitz flank Crosby. The other winger for Detroit, Daniel Cleary. Lidstrom and Rafalski, the defense that he's had to face in all the games here at Joe Louis Arena. He has come up with no points in the three games here. Played ahead and too far for Cleary and back down. This will be the first icing as Pittsburgh didn't arrive in time. Cleary out-hustled Gonchar. Gonchar hit by Datsyuk. Cleary able to take it around behind. Some lumber came there from Orpik, tipped around by Crosby, and Crosby is able to get some help from Gonchar, and Pittsburgh, not with the kind of first shift it wanted, Detroit with one that it likes. Zetterberg, picked off, a rebound attempt by Cleary with popped up high. Along comes Zetterberg, pulled it free, leaned on a bit by Kunitz from his knees, gets back to his feet. Tried for Datsyuk, prevailing him. is Orpik, and Orpik led it ahead where Crosby is able to foist it on back.
What an effort by Dan Cleary. That pressure by the Red Wings was all started because of the hustle of Dan Cleary negating that ice. And
stick of Talbot moving back in and tying up with his man that time and trying to work it further was Bronson. It skipped back on and a hit on Letang. Escaped across now for Marian Hossa. So 90 eventful seconds for Detroit to start. Letang flips it off Conwell and offside is called.
Well, we've heard a lot from the players, but how about the coaches, Dan Bylsma? It'll be interesting, Doc, to see if Bylsma tries to get Sidney Crosby away from the matchup of Zetterberg and the defensive pair Rafalski and Lidstrom. And for Mike Babcock, saw him right before puck drop. Says it's very normal in his room. His team has been there, and he liked to push the pace, especially in offensive zone. And I got to imagine he loves that start, that little extra effort by Dan Cleary to negate the icing. Don't take it for granted. Win a battle, win a race, create a scoring opportunity, and a good stop early there by Marc-Andre Fleury.
Off this face-off battle, it slid ahead by Helm, but taken by Big Hal Gill and tipped back in by Matt Cook. Left to back to lay that one along. Michael Samuelson there. On to Helm, spiked away by Cook and sent aside by Chris Osgood. So Lebda wound it around behind. It's stoked on now to Holmstrom, who brings it ahead. No points in four games, out of character for Thomas Holmstrom as he watches this collision and comes by and finessed it free and tried to play to the front, but could not. Helm is there. Cook shoulder from him, the leading hitter in this final series. Jabbed on three, but Jordan Staal took over there. Described by his coach as the X factor in this series. Very impressive in Pittsburgh. Across it comes now to Matt Cook. Laid it on over for Tyler Kennedy, and Kennedy had to circle, and it trickled on back.
Got to get that puck in deep if you're Pittsburgh. End of a long shift. Get the puck at the red line. Know you're trying to make a play, but make sure you get that puck in deep. You do not want to turn the puck over in the neutral zone.
And Matt Cook just came off the ice saying that to the players on the bench. My fault, fellas. I got to get that deep.
Pierre McGuire located between the two player benches. This is angled back in, and Osgood is out to stop it and lay it back on. It's twisted around behind for further control. A single shot in the first 3 minutes of play, and that off a Red Wing stick. And it was in the first 15 to 20 seconds of play. This one bounced wide of Fleury in the cage. Thrown on back to Brooks Orpik. Stepped in two there, and it's pulled right free. And Maltby out in front, had it tipped off his stick by Pascal Dupuis, and regathered at center and flung on by Cromwell. Delayed offside is White. Another change by the Red Wings as it's sent back in by Miroslav Chatan. He is in place of Peter Sikora. Sikora had an injury to his foot blocking a shot. Laid back ahead, and this one skipped back in and can be played by Mark Eaton. Forced right back along, and it's off of Bill Guerin. Guerin, a Penguin who is empty in four games. Lidstrom a shot, and that went off a leg in front.
I think it was Chris Letang, Doc.
Limping around a bit. A backhander by Datsyuk saved, and then cleared away by Eaton. And it went through Rafalski and back to center.
Edge, are you surprised Pittsburgh's losing all these races, going back for pucks?
A little bit. I think there's some... just a little bit of tentativeness in their game right now, and Detroit is certainly keeping it very simple, Pierre.
Inside the glass is Pierre.
Thanks, Doc. You know, and that's the biggest thing for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Try to get the nerves out of the game early on, and we're seeing they're making uncharacteristic mistakes, going back for pucks, losing the pucks, not recognizing their outlets. If they keep losing those races, that's not a real formula for success. They've got to start winning those races and playing their skill and their speed game.
It's interesting what the coaches have said all along here. Mike Babcock says, let's execute and play in their end of the ice. Dan Bylsma of Pittsburgh says, let's make their defense go back and play in their end. Pretty clear what both teams want.
Yeah, after six-plus games, you know exactly the tendencies. You know the system. Now it just comes down to that execution.
Face-off win and a shot, and that went off a fallen Red Wing. It was Hossa. Max Talbot brought it ahead. Able to play further. Shouldered off by Cromwell. It's pitched back off his skate, but followed up by Rob Scuderi, one of the heroes of Game 6 for Pittsburgh. two-a-side battle. And it continues for the turn by Filppula. Pursued by Malkin. Laid a pass ahead. And it's taken by Hossa. Has Bronson breaking. Hossa carries in and tripled it on now to Filppula, who turns. Onto the back it comes. Fed back over for Brett Lepdek. Lepdek cruises to the corner and throws a bad angle shot off Malkin, and it off one.
Nice job there by Malkin, Doc, to deny Brett Lepdek that angle to get the puck to the net. He went down, kind of took away the shot, and forced Lepdek really in a no-man's land. Ended up having to elevate that puck up and over Marc-Andre Fleury.
Lepda turns with it there. Crosby's line is back out as this caromed off of Forfick, who's able to play it back out and up the wing now to Bill Guerin. Guerin's shot is on goal and carefully steered away by Osgood. Floated on by Cleary, and then he was masked by Kunitz. Right back ahead comes Henrik Zetterberg. Leading point getter for Detroit, closed off by Sidney Crosby, and it squibs along now to Gonchar. Outletted for the jab across by Kunitz to Guerin, and again back in, and Osgood out to get it. Helps it on to Rafalski, lays it back off the boards and down, and it will go for an icing touch-up.
Going to go back to that play by Evgeny Malkin. Watch the play. Now stop it right here. Here's the lane, right? Now watch Evgeny Malkin. Watch what he does. He goes down, he denies the lane, and then it forces Lepta to go to the outside. If he doesn't go down, that opens up that lane. So buying time, forcing Lepta to a worse angle than he originally had because Malkin went down. I thought Malkin was outstanding in his own zone in game six.
Rafalski is crunched by Matt Cook. Wants to start the hitting back for the Pittsburgh side of things after the Red Wings have out-hit the Penguins early. Nearly 6 minutes played. Two shots Detroit, one shot Penguins. Hal Gill goes back to take this one. Rimmed right off. Just a gentle nudge that came on from Helm. Tip back further and battles for it. Eventually sped on by Jonathan Erickson.
I think that's Helm's third hit already, Doc. We haven't even played 7 minutes yet.
Not a large guy. 5'11", 172, but the hit leader in this series. You always think of big guys doing that.
He has that great speed to be able to put himself in that position to be a great puck pursuer, to force turnovers and just put pressure on defense and going back to puck.
Samuelson duels with Jordan Staal. It is sent across by Cook. Mark Eaton with a shot, and that one turned us on. Helm got out of the way of some of the hit coming from Kennedy. Ford battle escapes now for Lepta to play. University of Notre Dame product just holds back behind. Carried back on by Lepta. Drilled back wide on an offside call. 6:48 gone. First period. Scoreless in Detroit. Ladies and gentlemen, Muhammad Ali is in the house wearing a Red Wing jersey, and the fans are giving him a standing ovation and chanting his name.
Both benches as well, coaches clapping in behind, players tapping their stick. A sign of respect, one of the greatest athletes ever in the tennis tonight.
Had a three-round bout with an Edmonton Oiler named Dave Semenko in Edmonton. It was a lot of fun for both. They said, Filppula, a shot that went wide. Semenko was well known for being a pretty good fighter himself, but a hockey-style fighter. Meanwhile, this is laid back in by Talbot, and the rest is for another time.
One tough customer, Dave Semenko.
Hossa slipped that one back down. Will it go for an icing? Nope, icing is waved off. Every play is met by a hit from Detroit. They were out hit in Pittsburgh in game six. Around it comes for Rafalski. Reversed it on for Nick Lidstrom, but it was a weak one, and he has to take it himself. Zetterberg flies on. Got it on to Pavel Datsyuk. Impressive in game five after missing seven due to a foot injury. Letang duels with Cleary. There's more, and it comes to Datsyuk with Zetterberg near the front. Got a stick on that, but in the way was Mark Eaton. Taken by Crosby. Run into there by Cleary. Crosby shuffled it on. Intercepted by Datsyuk. Squibbed across though to Guerin. Datsyuk gets back up, and the fans wanted a penalty.
And look at how fell defensively by Billy Guerin coming over after Datsyuk stole the puck. Support in numbers, Doc, whether they have it or not. Detroit points, always got people around that puck, and then Garen did a nice job coming out and bailing out Crosby after he turned the puck over.
The NHL has gone with very experienced referees tonight. Phil McCreary, his 22nd, 7th game. Paul Dvorsky, his 7th. Ahead now comes Helm. Came back to left on the shot, hit Helm, and another shot! And getting a piece of that was Fleury. Quick recoil by the Detroit Red Wings there. It's played back in by Lehta. Off of Helm, but taken by Holmstrom. Tries to reverse and can't. Wrapped up by Hal Gill. Pulling his way along is Holmstrom. Shuttled it back to the point. It's kept by Erickson, but given up in front to Scuderi. Kennedy plays it safely back to Gill. Followed up by Kennedy. Kennedy crosses. Got loose and shot one off the outside of the cage. Then sent one in front of the shot. It's kicked aside. Loose puck in front.
This puck, I believe, goes off Tomas Holmstrom. And then here comes Tyler Kennedy. Brett Lepke backed up. But watch the move there by Tyler Kennedy. Little fake inside out. He stays with it. And then Jonathan Erickson denies Jordan Staal. And then Helm pushes that puck into Chris Osgood. But what a move there by Tyler Kennedy. Look at Jordan Staal. Comes to that area, stops in front. And then a good block shot there by Erickson.
Stewart and Cronwall, the defense for Detroit. Turned back over and swatted back in away from Chetan. Stewart run off by Chetan. It's helped along by Kirk Maltby, owner of 4 Stanley Cup championships, wanting a 5th one tonight. You hear the chant. There are a lot of Penguins fans here tonight as well, wearing black and gold or that powdered blue. Osgood helped it along. Settled down there by Craig Adams. Side of the net, Dupuis. Good cancellation from the defense of Stewart, who's right back to work on Dupuis again. Drops it off to Adams. The Harvard guy turns now, trying to shake Stewart. He's given a little shove down on defense, and play continues. Hudler flips it back out. Draper lobs it in, and the Penguins must retreat again in a full-scale set of shift changes. Cross for Eaton. Notre Dame product sent it back in and caught a man offside. Past the halfway point of the first period, the probing continues. Neither team has scored.
No score here in game number 7. Mike, you were just talking about what you're going to do on the back check. You're happy with the forecheck. What about the back check?
Well, it's a pretty good game. We're doing a pretty good job. They've come out. I was talking more about their set breakout. We've been too passive. Why be passive? Why give up the line? Let's stay on top of them. We're off to a pretty good start. We got to shoot the puck more.
Thanks, Mike.
Thank you.
Yeah, that set breakout that Mike Babcock was telling Pierre is when the defenseman for the Penguins get in behind the net, gets set up, yet people start to, oh, that takes a crazy bounce on Fleury. He stays with it, comes out, and doesn't let the puck play him. The play that he's talking about, the set breakout when Pittsburgh has the puck in behind it. And there's the dump in by Johan Franzen. One little bounce, and then he comes out and he makes sure it makes himself look big, gets those shoulders square, and gets the puck on edge. Takes a high bounce there on Fleury.
The curse of goaltenders. Mike Babcock's old school McGill was where they sawed the size off a ball and it became a puck over 120 years ago. He spent 1 year there in graduate school, and his old teammates were back for game 5 here. And he wore the school top. Here's Malkin, handing it on now to Hal Gill. He trickled it back in, and Stewart goes back for it. No icing here, yanked it around behind, and it's Cronwall forcing it back up for Franz.
A good hit there by Fedotenko, Doc, on that initial dump in by the Penguins.
Bouncer nudged on by Hossa, taken by Filppula. Up the wing is Franzen, but Filppula was chased off effectively by Fedotenko.
The stick and breaking the stick of Evgeny Malkin. But here, left part of your screen, there comes Nicholas Cronwall on Maxime Talbot. That's a timing play, trying to meet him and the puck at the same time. Talbot lets it go. And then as this puck continues on,
Evgeny Malkin in on a forecheck. Watch Brad Stewart right across. Malkin drops the stick. Referee Bill McCreary right in front. And a slash on Stewart. So an opportunity for the Penguins on the power play.
Pretty graphic evidence for Bill McCreary to make that call after the slash by Stewart, the broken stick.
Bud Light power play is on. Penguins are empty in the last two games, but here's Malkin feeding one in front. It wouldn't go. Knocked away by Cleary. Fed on back to the point now for Gonchar. Gonchar holds, hands over to Crosby. Gives on to Malkin, breaks, and they change positions. It's given back for Crosby, but it escaped over to Bill Guerin. Normally the front door player. It is Crosby out in front, fed it across. Oh, Malkin puts the end of the pass. Gonchar very deliberately shoots one. Tipped aside by Osgood. Diving sweep by Cleary, but it's kept along now by Letang. Worked back in deep and fed back to Letang by Guerin. Over to Gonchar. Drugged it on now to Malkin. Has Crosby side of the net. Malkin with a shot. It's wanded out of the air. Stick of Osgood. Sent back along again for Bill Guerin. Duels there, still deliberates and is able to hang on to it. Peeling off was Lidstrom. Guerin made a play to Malkin, then on back to Gonchar. Then on to Malkin again, halfway through the penalty kill. Malkin deals it in. It hopped off Crosby's stick, but he recovered. Letang with it there. Guerin at the front. It's dealt to the back to Gonchar. Every Penguin standing at the bench. Malkin with it there. Delays and then moves on. A shot is deflected across. On the power play, off of Osgood, taken by Kunitz, fed to Chatan, handed back to Eaton. Back on for a play by Kunitz again. Looks for Chatan, and it's chased down, so he has to hand it back to Gonchar. Crosby with it there. Five left. Threw one in front, it went wide, and came all the way out. Out of the box is Stewart. Standing ovation for the penalty killer. Rafalski laid one ahead. Mark Eaton couldn't stop it at the blue line, and so now everybody recoils. One last change for Detroit. Lebda hands it across, rocketed ahead off of Holmstrom and out of play into the crowd.
What sustained pressure, but it was off a face-up. Look at the setup. One, two, three across. Now watch the support by Crosby, who takes the face-up. Two against one. You got numbers. Crosby come over in support. A little different wrinkle, putting two players up on the strong side. An outstanding different setup there for Dan Bylsma. The Penguins on a power play.
And Sidney Crosby, you don't see Nicholas Lidstrom overplay like that. Bad body position by Lidstrom, but what athleticism by Crosby trying to create a wraparound opportunity.
Penguins got two power play shots. Their total in the game is five shots on goal. Detroit's is four, and we're even nearly 14 minutes play. Continues. Fed on back for Kennedy. Stahl tries to turn by. Erickson locked up with Kennedy and Lebda. Meanwhile, it's fed in front to Stahl, and he can't pull a good trigger on that turnaround shot, and Osgood blocked that one from Kennedy's stick.
This is where the Penguins want to play, below the goal line. Had great success the other night in game six.
The shot by Helm on Skinner. Helm is rammed. Skipped on over to Letang. Dropped around behind off the stick of Lidstrom to be taken by Dupuis. Headed back along to Cook behind. He's got Talbot in front. Gets to the back to Letang. Chased down by Maltby. Swung one blindly that came over to Lidstrom. Set for Maltby. And Maltby is able to motor ahead and drive it back in from the checkered line. Lurie sets it up there and banked one on that eventually is sent to Dupuis.
He was out there for almost the full 2 minutes of that power play, coming right back about a minute and 30 later.
Zetterberg is out there too, laid along now for Stewart. Zetterberg with a shot that's deflected wide by Eaton, tapped on further and along to Bill Guerin. Pass
Massachusetts-born winger lobbed that one on back where Stewart can take it away from the pivoting Crosby. Crosby tried to make contact with the puck with the stick, but it is Zetterberg flipping one that is cut off by Kunitz. Lobbed out of play into the Red Wings bench. 4:16 to go. First period. No score. How noisy is it down there, Pierre?
It's pretty noisy. Of all the games we've done in Detroit this year and this postseason, Doc and Edzo, I'd say this is probably the loudest this crowd has been.
Has the jabbering back and forth been as prominent tonight as prior games?
No, more about focus right now, calm, cool, and collected behavior from both teams.
Sent back in by Datsyuk, chipped away from Zetterberg. Off of Datsyuk, tries to gain the zone, and it's an offside. Expand your hockey experience on NBCSports.com and NHL.com. Right now and throughout the game, we're streaming a live ISO cam of Sidney Crosby. When he's not on the ice, we'll follow another star player. We only have about 15 to pick from. It's available right now at NBCSports.com and NHL.com.
We're run out of time thinking about all the different players on both sides. A lot has been made of Marian Hossa with only 3 assists, no goals so far in the Stanley Cup final. Sidney Crosby's had a goal and 2 assists to this point. I think that has a lot to do with the people that he's playing against almost shift after shift, especially here in Detroit with Mike Babcock and the Red Wings having that last game.
It's knocked off the stick of Helm, a rising shot got the glass.
Doc and Eddie, this is a line that's starting to percolate for Pittsburgh right now. Cook's been physical, Kennedy wins races, and Stahl's got great hockey IQ. They've got to stabilize this line through the Detroit Red Wings right now.
This was the unit that was trouble in game 6, and Kennedy's shot is clutched to the chest of Osgood. Inside the glass with Pierre.
Well, the positive things for the Pittsburgh Penguins just happened, but for the Detroit Red Wings, they're thrilled to death with a lot of their forechecking right now, and it comes down to winning races and get bodies on, like this situation with Danny Cleary winning an icing situation. Darren Helm hard on Hal Gill. That's what you want. Get the defenseman for Pittsburgh to go back. So the winning the races is good for Detroit, but they've got to find a way to corral the third line. They're doing a good job on Crosby and a good job on Malkin.
Good hit again by Fedotenko. And he's able to control this. Tripled it behind for Malkin. Malkin out in front. Slipped a little backhander in front that's guided away by Brad Stewart and carried back out again. Bringing it on now is Marian Hossa. Drops it on back for the delay and then tripled it down. Rafalski goes to get it. Rafalski had trouble with that. Knocked away by Chetan and controlled. Cycled back on the backhand now for Kunitz. Kunitz wanted to turn and lay it further. Nick Lidstrom in the way, and it's jammed on back to center. Crosby dumped it back in. Nick Lidstrom has won the Norris Trophy for best defenseman 6 times. He is assigned, as well as his Zetterberg and Datsyuk, to Crosby. Jammed in front and grabbed.
Well, a couple of great chances. Hossa to Filppula. Watch the move right there inside, and then the continued pressure, and then a poke check by Marc-Andre Fleury, and then right back. Watch Marian Hossa. Watch what he does. He doesn't stop in front of the net, and there's a big rebound. If Hossa goes to the front of the net and stops in front, he might have a gigantic opportunity. But if he goes by the net, you have no chance. But a simple play by Filppula. A big rebound given up by Fleury. Hossa wants to score. He's got to stop in front of the net. He might take a stick. He might take an elbow. Right around the front. Oh, and it's swept away by Fleury. What a chance there for Maltby.
Sent around behind and taking it is Hudler. Reverses, trying to shake Skinnerian. He does. Hudler onto the back. Left a one-time shot. Went wide. Tumbling to the ice is Maltby. Puck kept alive and sent behind. Tipped on for Skinnerian for Pittsburgh. Catching along and keeping play alive for Detroit was Lefkin. Three-man battle, and it went free for 2 more to try. Skinnerian and Maltby are there. Stahl able to step away with it. 1:35 to go. First period. Shots are 8-6 Pittsburgh. The intercept by Lefkin carries back in. Hudler near the net, and the shot was over the glove hand of Fleury. Hossa able to emerge with it. Has a
Bruins looking for Draper for a high tip.
No icing here. Both teams get a rest as they change lines. Bosa able to weave his way from one. Carries back ahead from Malkin. Moves and shot one that was slowed down. Didn't get much on it. Bosa there closed off by Malkin. And Malkin is able to flip one that came on back. Sent further by Fedotenko, and Talbot will get there first. Drew one off the outside of the cage. Kept alive by Letang. Set back in for Fedotenko. Set it one in front, and it went off of Max Talbot as he was checked tightly at the front of the cage. Now it's fed to Letang. Left it behind, overskated by Phil Philip, brought on by Fedotenko. 35 to go. Fedotenko, fed one in front. Talbot a shot. Blocked it. Rolling play. Kept alive. Around behind again. In the way was Malkin, but Fedotenko has got it. Pivots trying to shake a tired Stewart. Fedotenko turning behind with 20 to go in the period. Further through Talbot. Malkin cannot get there. Taken along by Zetterberg, and he takes his own pass off the boards with 10 left. Zetterberg moving back in. Has a man with him. Pulled up. Could not get the shot away. Comes to lift from 2 to go. Shot just over the glove hand of Fleury. And the first period is over.
For the Penguins, and they came on, but how about the chance by Kirk Malpe, the glove of Marc-Andre Fleury, Malpe trying to elevate it, and the quick glove of Fleury, and at the other end, opportunity. Ruslan Fedotenko out in front of Maxime Talbot, Nicholas Cronwell down, a block shot with Osgood sprawling. Some great opportunities, but I think, Doc, for the Penguins, they've had success playing below the goal line in the offensive zone.
11 Stanley Cup banners in those rafters. Will there be 12? Coming up in the intermission, Darren and Mike on Detroit's physical play, Marc-Andre Fleury save, plus Nick Lidstrom and his legacy. It's building, and he's still playing. Shots on goal in the period. 10 for Pittsburgh, 6 for Detroit. 20 minutes in the books. There is no score. Here again, Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Two great covers from the past. 1992, Mario Lemieux and the Pens win their second straight Stanley Cup. And in 2008, the Detroit Red Wings winning their 11th. Who will be on next week's cover? For more great SI covers and 55 years of SI history, go to si.com/vault. Mario Lemieux has been named to the Order of Quebec, the most prestigious honor in the province. He receives the rank of knight in a ceremony in Parliament next Wednesday. Nick Lidstrom, 235th career playoff game, fourth on the all-time list. Only Chris Chelios, Patrick Waugh, Mark Messier are ahead of him. And he passes to Rafalski as we get things going in the second. Fleury paddles it on. Gonchar jammed one through Datsyuk. Set up for the carry by Crosby on to Kunitz, but interrupted by Lidstrom and then spun back into the Red Wings' end. Should we get time, I'd like an evaluation on how the matchups went in the first. But let's see if we get time here in the second as Crosby delays now. And then shot one that went wide. Bounced back on for the keep now by Horvick and around to Kunitz. Not much room to work, but he does. Screened off a bit with Rafalski. Horvick tapped it back in. Gotten by Bill Guerin. Watched very carefully by Zetterberg, as is Crosby by Lidstrom. Crosby tries to get loose and can't. It's taken back out by Datsyuk. Datsyuk moves ahead, chopped one back in, and Crosby is able to send it right in front of his own net to Horvick.
Remember the play in the first period, Billy Guerin taking the puck away from Datsyuk. There it was, Datsyuk taken away from Crosby. Good positionally there by Datsyuk in his own zone.
Oh, a giveaway around in front of the shot.
What a turnover by Brad Stewart. He lost the race in the first period to Maxime Talbot, and now he turns it over to Talbot.
Shoot in by Brooks Orpik. Left part of your screen. There goes Brad Stewart. Talbot's in on a forecheck. He tries to make the pass up the middle of the ice. It goes off the skate of Evgeny Malkin right to Maxime Talbot. A little bit of patience and then right under the legs, between the legs. Watch the stick of Osgood. He goes down, lifts up the stick, goes right between the legs. 1-0. 1-0 lead.
Seventh of the playoffs for Max Talbot. Third in the series. It's fired around and away from Cook. Retreating to play now is Brett Lebda. It's always interesting to see who comes out after a goal to score, either for or against. It's the stall line for Pittsburgh. It's the helm line for Detroit with Holmstrom and Samuelson. Rifled around behind the fence of the Penguins. Samuelson with a shot that is tipped by Holmstrom and wide. Tipped on around and Helm tossed it free. Samuelson peels away, rides the blue line with it, trying to get good body position and a penalty coming up. It's Erickson, a shot, and it sailed wide. Touched up by the Penguins. Power play coming up. The call is a hook.
I think we have two. I think we're going to Thomas Holmstrom for a rough on Hal Gill, and Jordan Staal's going to get a penalty as well. I think it's going to be matching minors. Here's the first penalty to Staal.
Was the penalty that was awfully soft, I'll tell you.
That's a penalty, but then later on down low, Holmstrom gets one as well. So Staal's in the box for Pittsburgh. Holmstrom for Detroit.
Now we're gonna go back to the goal here. Here's Brooks Orpik. Stop it right here. Look where he is and look where he shoots this puck in. Here's the red line, right? He shoots his puck in on his own side of red line. That should have been an icing call, but the linesman negated it. Now Brad Stewart tries to get it to Valtteri Filppula. Off the skate of Malkin. Talbot puts it in behind Chris Osgood.
Four against both. Rapolski with a shot deflected, and it went off the shoulder of Fleury and is carried back out by Kunitz. Moving back up with Sidney Crosby. Kunitz the shot, and that one knocked down by Rapolski. Carefully played on for the carryout now by Datsyuk. Datsyuk trickled it back in and goes to get it. Gonchar there with him. Picked up by Zetterberg. Fed back to Rapolski in a shot, and that blocked away to the glass. And then shuttled on by Kunitz, but it bounces right to Datsyuk. Played it off Kunitz, and it's tipped back to center. The Red Wings have had 26 minutes of 4-on-4 in these playoffs and have not scored a goal, 4-against-4. But here's Cleary trying to change that and tie the game. Shouldered off to the glass by Orpik. Gonchar laid it onto the stick of Malkin. Moves up with Crosby. They're out there together. Malkin a shot. It's grabbed and held by Osgood.
So we saw Jordan Staal take his penalty, which was a minuscule play. And here's the rough on Thomas Holmstrom. You see him haul down Hal Gill. The battle down low. And Paul Dvorsky makes the call.
And a 2-on-2 in this 4-on-4 situation, using the defenseman as a screen, skating left, shooting right, trying to get Osgood down in between. Nice execution there by Evgeny Malkin, a good stop by Chris Osgood.
In all of their playoff games, the Penguins have scored only 2 goals, 4-against-4, one of them in this series against Detroit. But here is Skinner. Fedotenko, sized up by Filppula. Fedotenko brought it on. Shot one that was blocked high, and everyone looking for it. And we get a halt to play. With NBC Sports Mobile, you can stay up to date during the offseason with NHL news plus scores from all your favorite sports. Just text the word hockey to 51515. That's letters H-O-C-K-E-Y to 51515.
Playing 4-on-4, it's man-on-man. Defensemen have forwards, forwards have the defense. Can't afford any miscommunication, not knowing your assignment. A lot more open ice.
Puck shuffled back in by Stewart. Fleury, a little trouble, sent one off the glass. It's grabbed and eventually started back out to Talbot again. Talbot moves up with Dupuis. Flew one across that spiked away by Osgood. Dupuis tried to nub it on and got it through to Talbot again. Cycled it on to Dupuis. Matched there by Cronwall. Takes it right away. Swedish-born defenseman able to accelerate, trying to get away from Dupuis. It's handed across for the shovel back in by Hossa and around to Fleury, the goalkeeper. Played back into trouble. Hossa looks there and has Datsyuk and plays to it. Both teams have gotten a man back. Gonchar steps to this one. Hossa honking him. It's Cook trying to fly it through, and it goes all the way to Rapolski.
A couple tired defensemen out there for the Red Wings. Gonchar and Orpik. See if Detroit can take advantage of it with the long change in the second period.
Further to the bench this period, Fleury in some trouble. Gets back to his goal crease again. Two scary plays for the Pittsburgh goalkeeper. Rapalski flew on one. Gonchar moves in and Samuelson after him and mashes him as it's sent on back as far as Rapalski.
Still can't get off.
It is Holmstrom yet again.
Brian Rafalski up to Tomas Holmstrom, right part of his screen, it's Darren Helm. What a stop there by Fleury, a quick little poke check with Samuelson looking for a rebound. And then Brian Rafalski tries to get this puck in deep. A good shot blocked by Cook, and he's off to the races. Unfortunately for Cook, the puck went a little bit too far to his left, so he lost his angle, and that allowed Rafalski at the last second to put a little bit of a body on him. But Cook follows in on Osgood, but a good stop by Chris Osgood.
Lidstrom on to Rafalski. Nearly 5 minutes played in the second. One Detroit shot, three for Pittsburgh. 13-7 Penguins in the game.
Little line juggling going on here. Franz and Cleary in Zetterberg.
Guerin and Kunitz and Crosby. And a shot by Guerin was blocked away by Crosby. Or checked that by Osgood. As Crosby was nearby, this is carried on back by Zetterberg. Peels off and then shot one that went wide. Kunitz there. The probing continues. Crosby wraps up with Franzen. And Crosby hunched over, apparently hurt on this play, and he will try to get to the bench. No penalty forthcoming. This is Scuderi dropping it on out of Kunitz. Crosby not at the bench yet until now. Tapped back across and Filppula is there. Filppula holding through traffic, drives it back in on the back end. But it's behind a Hal Gill. Sped it along and Stewart could not keep and it goes back.
Boy, I thought Crosby was going to get a penalty as he goes into the dressing room in behind the Penguin bench. I thought Crosby was going to get a penalty for holding on to Johan Franzen. They came together and you're right, Doc. It took him a long time to get to that Penguin bench.
The Detroit bench felt the same way about the Crosby play to hold on Franzen.
Here comes a penalty to the Penguins.
Hal Gill. Sorry, Doc. Detroit Red Wings, Hal Gill tying up Pavel Datsyuk. A little bit of line juggling going on by Mike Babcock, and Sidney Crosby gets hit by Johan Franzen in the left leg, and look at the reaction of Crosby. Immediately, the left leg up against the board after the hit by Johan Franzen, and there you see Crosby getting help. Assistant equipment manager Paul DeFazio and the medical staff of the Penguins.
Power play is on. The Bud Light power play sent on now by Hoodler. Around it, Franz shooting once. They jam away and it popped around behind the try. Came from Zetterberg. And it started back ahead by the Penguins and Craig Adams. Moves out with Talbot. Getting back defensively as Zetterberg. The shot by Adams is trapped and then held by Osgood.
Good idea by Henrik Zetterberg at the other end, Doc. Just taking the puck hard to net, forcing the Penguins to defend. Fleury down. And then Zetterberg did an outstanding job of coming all the way back on that back check. Turned that two-on-one into a two-on-two because he worked his rear end off through the neutral zone and denied Craig Adams a real good scoring opportunity.
Zetterberg waved out of the faceoff, so Franzen moves in against Staal. Two big men tie up, and it's swept away by Zetterberg. Nearly a minute and a half to go on this power play. Talbot from Malkin at 1:13 of the second for Pittsburgh, the only goal in the game. Offside was Samuelson.
And he was screaming for the puck right through the neutral zone. He was yelling, Hank, 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 and Zetterberg couldn't hear him. It was too loud. But he would have been all alone, and Samuelson comes off the ice shaking his head.
Quite a year. 8 months ago, Pittsburgh opened the season in Stockholm. Tyler Kennedy with a couple of goals and an overtime win over Ottawa. Detroit opened the season here and lost to Toronto, one of their rare home losses of the year.
this year around now. Brought back ahead by Rafalski with a minute 10 to go. Fed on through for the carry by Hossa. Darts away from one and rattle it around the board. Jammed on by Holmstrom, read by the defense, and Scuderi was able to clear and comes to the bench for a change.
Two plays on this penalty kill for Rob Scuderi. The first one was on a backhand, and then there on the forehand. Great support by the penalty killers of the Penguins.
Datsyuk sent it to Rafalski and back on to Pavel Datsyuk again. Jammed it on three, and it's Hossa. Has Holmstrom behind and gave it to him there, but it was tangled in the referee's skates. Then sent back on to Holmstrom again. Tried to poke it to the point, but it's cut and started out again by Talbot. He's out there all the time, this guy, and a shot that was over the glove hand of Osgood. Talbot tangled up with Lidstrom, and it's laid back across for Hossa, who glides on with it. Gains the zone. Hossa dropped it off to Franzen. Johan Franzen led it on back to Lidstrom, who looks across. Rifled it back in deep. Datsyuk had trouble with that. Then sent it back across. Cronwall a shot! And that one rattled wide. Came back on now for Pavel Datsyuk, who delays and shakes it on back to Lidstrom again. 3 seconds left, power play. Cronwall with it. Lidstrom one time shot. Followed by Fleury. Scramble in front there, and it's taken around and pulling the referee. It's cleared back and fresh from the box is Gill. Had trouble stopping it. Gets there and chopped one that went around behind.
That would have been a 3-on-1 if Al Gill could have controlled that puck. What a smart play by Lidstrom, recognizing Gill couldn't get to the puck.
And how about the stop by Fleury off the shot by Nicholas Lidstrom?
Shot back in by Cleary, grabs at his face. Meanwhile, it's nudged out by Eaton, carried on by Malkin. Up the board, Fedotenko. Fedotenko canceled there with Cronwall, but kept going and punched it on around to Letang. Stewart jostled off by Dupuis, charges after it and got it. Dupuis fed it on through. Fedotenko's pass is directed back out, and Franzen can lay it on now for the carry back by Cleary. Has a man breaking it, Stewart. That went by him and rode up the body of Fleury, who can recover. Inside the glass, here's Pierre.
You know, we know defensemen, what they have to do down low. We know what goaltenders have to do down low. And we also know that the goaltender can also be an activated defenseman. In this case, Chris Osgood, on that last play, does a fantastic job with the puck coming out front. It's his stick that bats the puck away from traffic, and he starts the breakout. And that's what you need to have. You have to have your goaltender aware at all times. And Chris Osgood, while he's giving up one goal, he made a real good play there against Ruslan Fedotenko.
Looking down in the bench area, no return of Crosby yet. Played back off the glass and soccered back on by Helm. Closed off effectively with Samuelson by Hal Gill. Stahl connects across. It's lugged back out by Bill Guerin. Tries for Chris Kunitz off the boards, but it came to Osgood, threw it back. Kunitz controlled, but gave it up to the defense, and it's played on by Helm. Brett Lepta brings it on, crisply ahead to Samuelson, and a shot went off Hal Gill, and then Samuelson bumped into by Gill, and 20,000 referees thought there should have been a call.
And during the regular season and the first three rounds of the playoffs, they'd be right.
Sure has changed, hasn't it?
Sure has.
Helm with a pass that spiked back in again, and going back for that is Gill. Samuelson tangled with him, and Hal Gill prevailed. Big 6'7", 250-pound defenseman sees this played right back along by his defense partner, Scuderi. Swatted back out, and a two-on-one developing. Moving in is Talbot up the wing. A shot! He scores! Max Talbot with two goals in the game, and it's 2-0.
Oh, that's all Brad Stewart again. Max Talbot's in his head.
Well, what a defensive play, as you mentioned, Pierre. By Chris Kunitz in his own zone. Stop it right here. The pinch by Brad Stewart, and then support forces the two-on-one. Kunitz wins the battle. Hudler comes over now, a two-on-one. And then the quick shot over the glove of Chris Osgood. Maxime Talbot looks, gets to the top of the circle, and what I love is he keeps that puck in a shooting position. He doesn't get it in front of him. No stick handling. Gets it in that position, and look at Osgood. Boy, oh boy, he seemed like he was off his angle just a little bit. Interesting to see what Darren Pang's opinion of Osgood's positioning there, off his angle a little bit. A lot of room on the glove side. But Kunitz, with a great play in his own zone, gives the Penguins a 2-0 lead.
Philpola turns with this. Laid it back to Rafalski, swung it across to Lindstrom. Angled off for Hossa. Battles at the back of the goal with Letang. He popped it up high. Philpola emerged with that. Hooked off a bit by Letang. Puck came back to Rafalski, swung across.
back on its moorings now. Lidstrom gets back over to Rafalski. Back to Lidstrom again. Lidstrom lifted one off those springy boards, and it came on down to Letang, who sent it back to center where Lidstrom must play.
Nice read by Letang. Lidstrom did that on purpose.
39-year-old defenseman and a veteran here comes to the bench for Detroit as this is taken behind by Mark Eaton. Chetan sailed along, and Chetan has this one. Down it back in deep, but it misfired for Malkin. Zetterberg swept it back along, and it's carried back out by Datsyuk. He has Cleary on the wing and carries it himself. And offside is called as Dan Cleary just a little over anxious. More after the whistle. 2-0 Pittsburgh in Detroit.
2-0 Pittsburgh leads over Detroit here in Game 7. Dan, first of all, update on Sidney Crosby, if you can.
He's going to come back. He's going to be back for sure. He's got a check, and he's got an injury in the midsection, but he'll be back.
Your team has clearly changed tactics here. We saw it on the power play in the first period and on the goal, and clearly what we're seeing right now is you're attacking off the forecheck. The guys are sticking to the plan. How do you make sure Detroit doesn't jump back in?
Well, just about managing the puck, keeping the puck out of the middle, making it their D go back for pucks, getting it behind them. And then in the offensive zone, you hang on to it. You don't make any hole plays. You put it behind the net. You keep control there, wear them down, and keep getting that puck to the net.
Thanks, Dan.
Thank you.
That was interesting. Doc and Pierre were talking about keeping the puck out of the middle of the ice. If you're going to play against the Red Wings, want to try to use the puck wide, and you're going to turn it over. Icing here against the Penguins. Keep the puck up the boards. A little safer than trying to make plays through the middle of the ice because of the transition game. And to this point, after a slow start, the Penguins and Maxime Talbot are up 2-0.
It is so often in Stanley Cup history that maybe not the top names on the marquee contribute heavily in a Game 7. Waved out of this one now is Jordan Staal. But Max Talbot has been prominent in these playoffs, going all the way back in particular to Game 6 in Philadelphia, Round 1. Seems like a long time ago. Thrown along by Orpik, kept alive by Hossa. Burrows back in. Hossa sending one and a kneeling block by Gonchar. And it's played ahead now for Staal. Up the wing now, it comes for Kunitz, and a shot is trapped and held by Osgood.
You know, Eddie, what we're seeing now, Sidney Crosby, we're seeing Jordan Staal a lot with Kunitz and Garrett. And Danny Bilesma is running a quicker bench right now because of the lack of Crosby being part of the Penguins equation.
Well, he's got a lot of different ways to go, Pierre, as you know. Evgeny Malkin. You got Maxime Talbot, who's playing on the wing usually with Evgeny Malkin on that so-called second line, but Talbot a natural centerman as well. So he can go a lot of different ways and just make sure he's rolling that bench. Being short one forward to this point.
Dan Cleary trying to go by Gill, who blocked it down. Coming by a Zetterberg to keep play going, but it's taken right away by Malkin. Stars stripping stars of the puck. Another one of the great things about this Stanley Cup final. Reversed along by Cronwall for Stewart, and Stewart touched it up the boards, and that's squibbed off of Malkin, and is carried ahead by Datsyuk. Moving on with Cleary, and he gets to it. Cleary is reached by Malkin and canceled out. Puck taken by Zetterberg, threw one in front, and it went off Cleary. Cronwall a shot, and sprawling in front of that one was Chetan, and we get a stoppage of play. A deflection out of play and no further action coming here.
A pressure point right now for the Pittsburgh Penguins attacking the Detroit Red Wings defense. What they're doing is chipping pucks in deep and they're attacking different players. And Brad Stewart's having a tough time. He takes a penalty because of the speed of Evgeny Malkin. He turns this one over to Malkin and ends up on the stick of Talbot. He scores the first goal of the game. And then the bad pitch on Kunitz. Kunitz makes a real skillful play to Talbot. It creates a 2-on-1. Then Talbot with the finish.
And also on that play too, I think you're Yuri Hudler and you see Brad Stewart along those boards, instead of coming over to the pile, you got to start coming back to the middle of the ice to keep that from being a 2-on-1.
Agreed. Centering pass by Helm would not work for a shot by Samuelson, so it's carried on back by Talbot looking for the hat trick. Adams there cancels with Lepta, and it is just flicked free for Jonathan Erickson. One of four rookie players for these Red Wings that have appeared in the Stanley Cup Final. All four of them coming from the Grand Rapids Griffins in the American League. If they win, it will be the first time the American League has produced four rookies that have been there over half a year and have appeared and won a Stanley Cup. But they're down by two, and here comes Kunitz with it. Kunitz backhands over the shoulder of Osgood. Sent around by Guerin, taken further by Kunitz. Another shot, and that went off of Brett Lebden. Thrown along by Gonchar. Stepping to it is Guerin. Off of Samuelson to Holmstrom, and led across now for Erickson.
Got to get Erickson and Lebden off the ice. They've had a long shift.
Erickson able to step by one, and offside is called yet again against Detroit. Konen's taking late night by storm, and tonight the laughs keep coming with guests Jamie Foxx and Kevin Nealon. Tonight's show with Conan O'Brien, right here on NBC. Evgeny Malkin, the leading point getter in the series, has a primary assist on the first goal by Max Talbot. Ian Filppula from this test. Dupuy tipped it back along and in, and Brian Rafalski out of the University of Wisconsin to play it. Under 6 minutes to go. Game 7, Stanley Cup Final. Detroit trailing by two, and another offside is called against the Red Wings. The shots are 17-12 Pittsburgh. 7-6 in this period. The Verizon Wireless sounds of the game. Chris Letang.
Hey, hey, go. Too quick. Why are you shooting at my foot? Gino!
Pretty calm during the warm-up, wasn't it? Get live game scores, stats, and alerts, and exclusive video on your Verizon Wireless VCast phone.
Detroit's got to find some sort of a burst. Seem to be in sync right now. Not much activity from their legs or their speed game. Passing a little bit off. Somebody's got to make a play. Somebody's got to get some energy.
Like Babcock himself. Go quick or stick too tight. We're okay.
Sent away by Fleury from the try by Datsyuk. Kennedy there. Lobbed on back, but it's taken by Dan Fleury. Shouldered by Orpik. Zetterberg laid it on back to the point, and it glanced off of Lidstrom and out.
The puck was bouncing off the boards. Good idea. It's a bad bounce for the Red Wings in the offensive zone. Good coverage down low by Detroit. Excuse me, by the Penguins.
Played on by Datsyuk again. Tried to shake his way by and got away from the hit of Warpik. Right around in front. It was lost momentarily by Gonchar, but played by Dupuy.
Michael Samuelson's got to go right through Sergei Gonchar. He's standing still. He has no outlet. He goes skating by. It gives the Penguins an easy out.
And with this now comes Malkin. Led it ahead, and Fedotenko was offside, and Malkin had somebody coming after him.
Yeah, Darren Helm again. And that's one of the guys, Beer, you know, that can really ignite the Detroit Red Wings with the speed, with the hitting. Malkin with the hit, and Helm the hit on Malkin. I think Malkin gonna give a little bit of a hip as well to Helm as he came over to make that hit.
Yeah, that was a potential dangerous play right there. But you're right about Darren Helm. His live legs can make a difference, and that's what Detroit needs right now. They need to get their legs moving. They got to start getting pucks in deep. They've only got 12 shots on goal, and we're almost done the second period. It's a team that's averaged over 38 shots a game in the playoffs.
No, good point. Do we make too much of all these offside calls where Detroit's just not too cohesive right now?
No, I don't. And I think Ojo would agree. The bottom line is Pittsburgh's doing a great job frustrating Detroit, and they got people in the right area. Look like that, and they got him some front ball.
Tipped back in again by Hossa. Careens to Fleury. Threw it right back up the boards. Battled for, but it skipped on for Malkin. Just made a casual play on back now for Stewart. Reached on to Filppula, tried to golf it in, could not. Laid a little pass along that Stewart is able to stoke back in, but it's right in the traffic of Mark Eaton.
Yeah, there's a simple play there. Stewart's just got to get that puck in deep. Detroit's going for a change. Tried to make a play. Bronson came across the blue line. It took a look out. Don't worry, he's a paid professional.
Along now with it is Bronson. Gave it on for the close-off that came on Helm.
A telltale sign Detroit is disjointed. There's no puck support. It's one guy up the ice and nobody helping.
Samuelson is shot that is held by Fleury. inside the glass, Pierre.
Well, a major problem right now for the Pittsburgh Penguins, even though they're leading 2-0, they're starting to wind guys up because there's no Sidney Crosby, and that's a devastating injury if they can't get him back. Think back earlier in this period in a race with Johan Franzen, and he goes for the puck. Franzen steps into him. Nothing wrong with Franzen did. We all thought Crosby was going to get a holding penalty. He doesn't get a holding penalty. He gets brought to the Pittsburgh Penguins dressing room, which is obviously not good news, but Pittsburgh really good right now, having a 2-0 lead, and Maxime Talbot, he stepped up. You know, last year in a game in Toronto, he actually came out and fooled the fans in Toronto. He wore Sidney Crosby's helmet, his number 87 sweater, and he went out, and all the fans thought it was Crosby. It was Maxime Talbot.
Ooh, that one is held on back now to Lidstrom. Drove one that ricocheted off Maltby. A try by Rafalski is tipped away from Hudler. Hudler behind, trying to turn away from Kunitz. Good defensive work done on him. Meanwhile, helping out and doing some repeated shoving is Draper. From one knee, Hudler got up, but Gonchar is able to take it and pitch one along that eventually is tapped back as far as Rafalski. Turned it right back on and flying right back with this, and holding now is a shot that came back from Stewart. Led back, but off a stick, trying to get to it, a stall coming over for it is Lidstrom, and he punched it back deeper. Now it is stall, lays it on back for a hurried shot that went wide. Chetan is shoved there by Chris Draper. It was he who had that chance back at the other end a moment ago. Here is Gill a shot, and that one went wide. Settled down by Kurt Maltby. He goes into the boards, but is able to jab it on further away from Adams. And playing it further is Talbot. The first nearly two periods that were in the Penguins' dreams last night. The way they wanted to unfold, icing is called.
We talk about the little things, Doc and Pierre. But the effort of Jordan Staal, good positioning defensively, good active stick. Now look at this foot race. Nicholas Lidstrom on the right, Rafalski on his left. He stays with it. He wins the battle. Remember the battle he won on that shorthanded goal earlier in the series back in Pittsburgh? That's the type of effort that a team that has a 2-0 lead in Game 7. That you're looking for.
A lot of the Penguins will tell you that shorthanded goal was a turning point in this series. Marc-Andre Fleury makes himself look big, but how many times have we seen the Red Wings take advantage of turnovers like that, Enzo? Yeah. And it goes right off of Cleary's right leg.
Yeah, good pinch in there by Jonathan Erickson, keeping the puck in, and then the shot by Nicholas Lidstrom going well off the net because there's bodies in that lane. But a good play getting the puck, Datsyuk to Zetterberg, and unfortunately for Cleary, trying to miss that shot, that high shot. He likes Zetterberg to try to keep that puck a little bit lower, knowing that Cleary's in front. Holmstrom's there. Franzen is there. He'll keep that puck low and force the goaltender to make a stop.
Driven along by Eaton and handled by Rafalski. Shuffled on back for Franzen. Moving in is Bilton. Defended by Gonchar. Down to the ice he went. Meanwhile, it's taken on by Hossa. Lidstrom, one time shot, and it went wide. Shot back further by Malkin, reached by Fedotenko, but taken away by Franzen again. Franzen dealt it back in deep. Posa shot that went off the leg of Eaton. Another try, and a save made by Fleury on Lidstrom. Now Rafalski tried to get it across. Lidstrom with it there. Threw it across the net, mouth wide. Fedotenko laid it back out again. A little bit of a surge by Detroit in the last minute and 21 of the second period. Handled by Staal up to Kunitz. And back in. Nelson and out of play.
Well, quick transition for the Detroit Red Wings. Puck up to Hudler and then the shot by Franzen. Seemed like it was blocked, hit Fleury, and then got in behind to Darren Helm. But what a great chance and a quick transition.
And you need guys with second effort. And Evgeny Malkin showing a lot of second effort during that same sequence as well. Dive and a knock a puck away from Nick Lidstrom. If he doesn't dive, Lidstrom gets that on his stick and he hammers it home.
Lidstrom goes back with Rafalski on this one. 25 to go in the period. Zetterberg out there as the pass goes through to Pavel Datsyuk. Able to pull away from a couple. Yanks it free to the corner and is able to, well, we thought he was going to play it along, but made a rare mistake, and so it's taken on by Zetterberg. Back to Datsyuk again. Some jostling at the front. Fed to the back. 7 seconds to go. Lidstrom lobs one, but it is cut off and then handed on back to Rafalski for a shot. Side the net.
Well, Datsyuk and Zetterberg working their magic using the defenseman, and Brian Falski tries to get this puck over to Henrik Zetterberg. He does. The puck is rolling, but the quick stick and the right pad of Marc-Andre Fleury denies Henrik Zetterberg. But the puck on edge, not able to shoot it right away because he's a left-hander skating towards Rafalski. Wasn't able to one-time that puck. But a surge, Doc, you use it. The word surge at the end of that period by Detroit.
Coming up in the second intermission, Darren and Mike on Crosby's injury, and Max Talbot steps up. Then Mike and Pierre tell you what the coaches should be saying to their teams in the locker room. Pierre with Maxime Talbot.
Two goals in this game earlier this year. You impersonated Sidney Crosby when you're in Toronto. Are you impersonating him now?
No, I don't think anybody can do that, but definitely feels nice to get two here. Have to do better in the third.
Max, you guys looked a little nervous to start the game, but now you've got your confidence. What did you do to get your confidence? How'd you get it going?
Oh, we were going day to day and chipping it and go put pressure. After we scored two goals, I thought we stopped playing a little bit, so we're gonna have to come back to the basic and play hard in the third.
Merci beaucoup. Thanks, Max.
Thanks, Pierre.
Mike Bilberry and Darren Pang when we come back. Talbot from Malkin at 113. Talbot from Kunitz and Scuderi at 10:07. The only scoring plays in Game 7. You're watching the NHL Stanley Cup Final on NBC. Sidney Crosby has returned.
Talking to assistant coach Tommy Fitzgerald. Took one little quick little twirl around the ice before going back to the bench. Getting hit with Johan Franzen early in that second period, did not take a shift the rest of that second period. And there he is to start the third.
I think the conversation with an assistant coach would be how well he feels so that the coach who might make changes would know.
I think so, Doc. And take a look at Nick Lidstrom, Doc. Here, 10 minutes and 28 seconds of ice time in that second period for the captain of the Red Wings.
Datsyuk against Staal to begin the third. Lidstrom and Rafalski. Zetterberg, or check that. No, right now it is Hossa and Holmstrom. Just considered it automatic. Should have looked more carefully. Kicked along now to Datsyuk. Along for Hossa. It is played off by Orpik. Taken now and worked on to Hossa for a quick shot that is off Fleury. Taken around now by Datsyuk again. Datsyuk with a nice move, but then it's spike free. Staal after it. Battles there and then wheeling around with the stick was Holmstrom. And it's loaded back out again by Gonsha.
A good start here for the Red Wings.
Remarkably, that one was chopped away by Datsyuk while he had fallen. But it is Kunitz turning back, and it's knocked right off his stick. Nice reversal along now by Franzen, but it is handled by Kunitz.
This isn't about defensive matchups for Detroit right now. This is about trying to generate some offense. So you're going to see lots of different line combinations. They won't be worried about defensive matchups at all. Now it's about attacking.
I guess I was just thinking that Zetterberg might be a good thing to use offensively as well as defensively, but he's out there now with Cleary and with Franzen. Franzen brings it on. Fed one for Cleary, canceled out by Scuderi, and then laid back out again by Chatain. Stewart's pass was stiffly off Zetterberg. Scuderi goes back, locked up there with Cleary. It's given up, though, to Franzen. Turns away from Hal Gill. Franzen reversed and threw it off Gill's big skate, and then it came to Fedotenko, lobbed it further, a kneeling block by Stewart, but it's pinballed off him to center. Cronwall gave it on back, and Cleary is able to delay and walk it off. That was off Chatan's stick and then laid back out again by Fedotenko.
Not yet seen Sidney Crosby.
He's still on right, next to,
right next to you, Pierre.
That one went through Lebda, and coming across is Jonathan Erickson. Nice pass ahead for Filppula. Filppula moving back in, trying to go by the defense and around behind. Filppula laid it on back for Lebda. Pushed it on further off Samuelson's stick. Lobbed on further and back. It is reached by Hudler. A diving challenge there came, but it is fed further for the play back to the point. A drive, and that one blocked away by Fleury from the stick of Erickson. A couple of players collide, but it's Samuelson trying to muscle it along. Jab free from him. Pumped on back, but Samuelson got there. Down to the ice he goes. There'll be a penalty coming up to the Penguins.
Penalty be on Mark Eaton, getting the stick between the legs of Michael Samuelson, and Samuelson making sure the referee sees that that stick is in there. So a gigantic power play opportunity for the Red Wings.
A huge power play opportunity for Detroit, but Sidney Crosby sitting right next to me right now, Edzo and Doc, and that's not good news for the Pittsburgh Penguins, and he's laboring right now on the bench. And he's laboring because of this play in the second period. In a foot race situation with Johan Franzen, he tries to go up and over.
Pretty good opportunity on the start there. Lidstrom then along to Holmstrom. Tried to jam it further, but emerging is Scuderi. Cleared, but it's off the glove of Rafalski to center. Carried right back in by Datsyuk. Forced it behind. Holmstrom wants to set up shot at the front of the net. Meanwhile, it's Hossa lobbing it along now for Thomas Holmstrom. Back to Hossa again. Then Rafalski has Lidstrom. Gets back on. Hossa moves. Shoots one, and it went wide. It's falling, and doing the splits that time was Fleury. Lidstrom onto Rafalski again. Back to Lidstrom once more. Hands over to Datsyuk, controlled in the skate. Got it on the stick. Datsyuk, drop pass over. Hossa shot, and it went off the fallen Holmstrom. Drive by Rafalski. Loose puck in front. And it's cleared back along, but not out yet. Punched on back to the point. Good pressure, Detroit. Lidstrom there. Fakes the drive. Scuderi down. Drive. Save Fleury, and he covers.
He's become Velcro. Edzo and Doc. One of the weaknesses of his game, juicy rebounds, not here in game number 7. When it matters the most, he shuts down on Nick Lidstrom, and there's no rebound for Thomas Holmstrom.
Well, a couple of missed opportunities. The shot by Brian Rafalski. Marian Hossa does a great job to keep that play alive, but Fleury upending Thomas Holmstrom as he was standing outside the crease. There's that little push in behind the legs, and it moving, so Holmstrom has nothing to fall on top of. But that battle inside, the big battle in front of the net.
Zetterberg won that crisply, but away from Cronwall, and so dropping back is Samuelson. Hudler and Franzen are the other Red Wings out to the last 50 of the power play. Zetterberg fed it across, drive, and it went wide of the glove hand of the cage, guarded by Fleury. Kill with Max Talbot, who has both goals in this game. Orpik and Gonchar, the defense, as this went through them. Charging back in is Hudler. No icing call. This careened across now for Talbot to lay it back down.
The Pittsburgh bench not very happy. Edzo, I don't know what you thought, but that was icing.
Cut them a break on that.
Very close.
Rafalski nudges it on, but it's through Zetterberg. In cleared again. Dozen of the penalty kill for the Penguins. Delaying is Lidstrom. Away from Adams, hands back to Rafalski. Away from Zetterberg. And again, it is Kunitz. Zetterberg dueling. Kunitz up
penalty kill. Sidney Crosby does not kill penalties. You got to think he's going to be on that bench the rest of the game if he hasn't seen the ice at this point.
Here comes Draper moving along. Backhands it wide. Bounced on to Malkin. Twisted it back, hoping for Draper again. Chipped in by Malkin and taken by Letang. They try the other way. It's directed by Fedotenko, but pinching along and throwing a shot wide that time was Erickson.
You see a lot of that. Detroit team, defenseman pinching down, trying to keep plays in the offensive going and jumping into the rough.
Brooks Orpik brought it ahead for the Penguins. And back in. If the score doesn't change, Crosby might not play in the third, but he'll have a hand in what happens after. Brought on now by Hudler, filtered through to Filtle. Filtle delays, no one at the point just yet. They try to work it deep. Samuelson drills it there. Along it comes to Filtle again. Hudler is given a little nudge there by Gonchuk. Puck came back. Stewart tried to shuffle it through, could not. Punch back out again, and Stewart retreats to play.
Good play by Jordan Staal on a couple ends there in his own zone.
Filtle moves back in with it again. Delays and gave it back for a shot, and that bounced around in front and hopped its way to the corner. Gonchar turned it along now for Kennedy. And then it came back for a try by Cromwell. Stoked on back for Samuelson. Can't settle it down. Gonchar threw it along. Filpula took it there. Pascal Dupuis is on Filpula. Chased him off. Down to the ice he goes. It's brought back by Staal and lobbed on back to center. Cromwell connects, cut off the stick of Hudler. And Eaton lobbed it back in. Chris Osgood touched it along there, and Cromwell is able to play it behind. 6.5 gone in the third period. Both goals in the second, both by Maxime Talbot of Pittsburgh. Here's Datsyuk delaying with it now. Around behind he goes and tried to one-hand it to the front, and he's ridden right off by Orpik. Guerin went down. Trying to play it further is Marian Hossa. Hossa kicked it along further and left it, got it. One-time shot, and it went wide off the glove of Fleury. Played it back out. Bill Guerin tried to settle it down. Cronwall came back defensively and then left it to take it and squirrel away from the forechecking Cook. Holmstrom able to bring it ahead. Then it's carried on by Rafalski, who tried to play it through but could not because of Fedotenko. Malkin got out of the way of Holmstrom. Laid across by Lindstrom to Rafalski, twisted back along, but Malkin has it there.
7:20. Sorry, Doc. Mike Babcock tells players their shifts are too long. That's why they're running out of energy.
It does look different, doesn't it? Especially when you see Lidstrom out there over 10 minutes in that second period. Some of it necessitated in that period by the long chains that both of you had pointed out, as this is carried on back now by Franzen. Backhands one, the Thompson skates, dug out by Cleary. Cleary had the huge goal against Anaheim. Hands it on now for Zetterberg. Zetterberg laid it on back to Lidstrom. Lidstrom chopped one off those boards, and it tipped back over where Kennedy was able to twirl a pass that was dangerous, but didn't get burned just yet because of Talbot pushing it to center. Satan moves it on, and Talbot races on. Denied by the defense of Lidstrom. Delayed offside is wiped as the puck bounces back near Zetterberg, given a good shoulder by Orpik. Zetterberg comes to the bench and a change. Samuelson accelerates on, gains the zone. Dropped one back, but it went off the defense. Carried back ahead by Kennedy and gently tapped back in again.
Absolutely out of sync in their passing, the Detroit Red Wings.
With this is Lidstrom. Gives it on to Filppula. 8.5 played, third period. Samuelson crosses with it. Knocked off his stick by Malkin. Filppula laid it on back. Erickson touched it across. Left it with it there. Left to flip one that is grabbed off by Hudler, set back on, but Filpula is rammed into there by Orpik. Filpula able to play it further, though. Touched it on back to left to first shot, and it was deflected. It went wide. Flipped on along, but not out. Kept alive by Erickson on to Hudler again. Hudler handed it back. Erickson with a drive, sprawling and blocking in front of Fleury, and it went off Orpik, and it's grabbed and sent back along, and it's through Lehto, charging after it as Malkin coming across as Erickson. Erickson bodied enough by Malkin that he could delay and get possession and peels away. Malkin fed one off the corner board. Popped off of Cook, closed off by Hudler. Cook dealt it back. Scuderi with it there. Lifted it along further. It is off Lehto and came right back up the boards where it can be turned but not out by Maltby. Booted right back on goal, and Osgood wisely holds on to this one. 10:25 to go in the third. And at Joe Louis Arena, it's still the Penguins by two. If you win your last game after 8 weeks of a collision sport, you get your name on this. 116 years old, the Stanley Cup. Bill Pritchard from the Hockey Hall of Fame polishing it up. Will Sidney Crosby be handed it at the end of the night? This is his first shift of the third.
9:35 into the third period. This is where the adrenaline kicks in. You know he's banged up. There are a lot of players on both sides banged up, but it is game seven.
Eaton tried to keep that one along, but it is dollared by the ref. Given away for a quick shot that went to the glass from Greg Adams.
Crosby did a lot of negotiating with the coaches to get on the ice for this shift.
Filippula moving along. Rolled one that is jabbed away by Fleury. Taken along by Letang. Letang plopped it back out. Bill Guerin had it knocked away and back to play it is Lidstrom.
Crosby's coming off and he's not feeling real good. He's just grim as he comes off the ice.
He didn't look too good right after the faceoff, did he?
No,
he's like he stayed there for a little bit.
He's talking to the trainer right now. I can't see him playing another shift.
Could be dangerous to do with a two-goal lead for a number of reasons. Zetterberg brings it ahead and is hopped there by Malkin. Reaches in and tries to pry it loose. Cleary there. Good shoulder on him again by Orpik, but it's taken on by Zetterberg. Zetterberg hopped by a couple, but is able to play it further for Cleary. Cleary just tried to muscle it along. Cleared by Malkin, but kept by Stewart. Stewart played it back in, and it careened on to Cleary for a backhand centering pass. And down to the ice went Franzen. Gets up without his helmet. Meanwhile, it's pitched back in again by Ruslan Fedotenko. No team has won the Stanley Cup coming from 0-2 down in two series in the same year. It's been done with one, but it's taken enough out of the prior teams they've never been able to do it a second time.
Once Detroit establishes offensive pressure, they got to start getting their defensemen involved. Their defensemen are staying outside at the blue line. They got to start trying to cause some confusion.
Here's Filippula shot, and that deflected up into the mesh. With 8:41 to go in period three, 2-0 the visitors.
We'll go back to the first shift. It's early in the second period for Sidney Crosby. Winning that faceoff over Pavel Datsyuk, fighting through it, whatever it is. When he came off the ice, obviously in some distress.
It is Lidstrom banging one off the boards. It's chopped loose in front and is helped along to Talbot, who scooped it across for Cook, who dealt it back in. And Cook goes near Osgood, who had to twist it away from the rushing goal. He angles it back. Bosa took it there, made the safe play back to Lidstrom. Down went Talbot. It's ahead now to Hossa. Hossa, the shot, save made by Fleury, and a big rebound. Is chopped on back to center.
So they're not getting any bodies to the net. In transition, Detroit, everything's to the outside. Nobody's getting in the net.
Pavel Datsyuk was there, but he went skating right by again. You got to start. There have been some rebounds. Not a lot. If you're a Red Wing player and you don't have the puck, you got to get to the front.
Here's Franzen, taken away by Dupuy, but followed up for a Karam shot, and now along with it is Dan Cleary. Cleary, fed one, shot by Franzen, and booted right back out again. Shaken up on the play is Bill Guerin. Chopped back on by Gonchar, and then fed back out by Dupuy.
Two good shot blocks by Pascal Dupuy. Real good shot blocks.
Loaded back on now, and Zetterberg can take it further. Zetterberg tried to feed it across and got it there. Cleary delays, shook it back off the boards to Franzen. Johan Franzen lost the duel with Stahl, and he's able to fly one that bounced on out the center, and Stewart didn't see it, so Cronwall has to come up. Pitched it back across now to Cleary. Leaned into by Letang, and the puck turned over to the Penguins again. It's Malkin firing it around, Fedotenko taking it there, a little over 7 minutes to go, and it's brought back on by Chetan. Has Fedotenko breaking, sent it across to him, and he could not reach it. Outletted, but blindly to center, the Red Wings might have been able to get an odd man rush out of it.
Cleary and Franzen were out of gas, as was Zetterberg. That was a problem, Doc. They were too long on the ice again, overextended shift.
And that pinch by Brian Rafalski gave the Penguins that opportunity on a two-on-one. But if you're Detroit, though, you got to start taking some chances.
Butler feeds Samuelson a shot, and he does it. It hopped right back out in front and is shoveled over for Chetan, who gave it up to Lidstrom. Hooked back along the half board, turning with it is Samuelson. Watched there by Letang, reversed it along on the backhand, and it's taken by Filippula. Filippula led it back. Lidstrom there. Shoots one to board sent on by Samuelson. Filppula fed it there, and Hudler is able to turn. Jammed it back through Filppula to Lidstrom. Sends it across for a shot.
Shake it.
blocking of Staal, who's able to take it, and then is shoved off just that quickly. Cleary in the way of the toss by Skinnerick. Zetterberg pitched it around behind. Franzen goes to this one. Laid it on to Cleary. Zetterberg near the front. Cleary to the back. Walking it across and turning his Cronwall. He's shot!
Generating a little bit of offense. Nicholas Cronwall jumps into play. Dan Cleary with a nice little play, a screen in front of the net, right over the head. It looked like it might even went off of Jordan Staal. Off of Staal, then off the crossbar, and behind Marc-Andre Fleury. Right over the right shoulder. Anticipating the puck coming to his left. Changes direction, looking around, trying to find this puck. But Cronwall with a quick shot. Right off the crossbar.
Dick Irvin, longtime coach of the Montreal Canadiens, Toronto Maple Leafs, who won Stanley Cups himself, used to speak of the unseen hand present in tight games. How a game changes with the unseen hand. Was the unseen hand made of iron there? Still a minute 17 to go. Pierre.
Well, Mike Babcock's going to tell his team what to do if they win the faceoff and what to do if they lose the faceoff. On the other bench, they're doing the very same thing. Obviously, Chris Osgood probably going to be coming to the bench. But Mike Babcock's a real good tactician. He understands what he wants. He also gets his better players, especially Zetterberg and Franzen, a rest. That was an extended shift for them, again, during that last sequence.
Yeah, it took a little while for that timeout to be called. It was probably at least 20 to 30 seconds before that timeout was called.
Edzo and Doc, that's Ray Shiro, the general manager of the Pittsburgh Penguins. When this building opened, the All-Star game was here in 1979-80. His father was a coach of the Philadelphia Flyers. He coached in the All-Star game here. His dad lost. Ray Shiro said, I want to come back here tonight and win this thing right here in Detroit. His father, Fred, won two Stanley Cups with the Philadelphia Flyers, and Ray Shiro had to make a courageous effort to bring in Danny Biles, but that was not an easy thing for him to do, and he did it.
Net empty, six attackers, 1:17 left. It's kicked on back and fed by Rafalski to Lidstrom. Back in deep, Cleary jabbed it on further. It's away from Datsyuk, picked up by Talbot, shoveled off the glass to center. Adams with it, flips one, and it's shrugged down by Lidstrom. Lidstrom fired it along, and it goes back down, and Cleary handles. Up the boards, Zetterberg. Threw one in front, it's cut off by Skinnerick, and set off the short glass back out. 50 to go. Rafalski sent it further, tipped along by Franzen, lobbed back in, and after it is Cleary, and Cleary able to turn away, and then it's buried by Staal. Up the boards it came, and Staal right after it again. Helped it along to Adams, played it to center, Lidstrom stopped it. Back on to Zetterberg again, and offside is called against Detroit, 32 left.
Good plays by the Penguins at their blue line, chipping the puck out. Maxime Talbot, Rob Scuderi with a good defensive play down low to get the puck to Jordan Staal. Chris Osgood back into the net, waiting for his team to get possession. If they do win this faceoff, he'll make a beeline for the bench.
Getting in too early repeatedly was Malkin, so he is chased out. Fedotenko to draw with Vilppula. Won it on back to Lidstrom. Osgood to the bench. Hasn't gone yet, but now it's thrown back in, so he will. Fleury out to get that. Scaled it back along. Blocked down, and Malkin gave it, but not out. Cronwall with a shot, and that one blocked to the corner by Brooks Harper. And tipped high on a deflection. No and an offensive zone faceoff coming up unless the Penguins win this argument. And the signal may be out to center.
Well, Chris Kunitz comes back, and there you see the pinch in. Went off the stick. I believe that's Valtteri Filppula pinching in down those left wing boards. Great's going to try to win this faceoff back to Nick Lidstrom.
A false start. Double check the clock. And again, Zetterberg and Staal. And again, encroachment on the faceoff. This time, Staal is waved out.
They can win this faceoff to Lidstrom. He'll try to hit Hossa going wide, or maybe a cross corner dump in to get that big angle and let Hossa get an opportunity to the left of Fleury.
Talbot and Zetterberg for this draw. Off the tie-up, it comes back, and they hand it over to Hossa with 12 to go.
You got to think about exercising your timeout and make sure you have all the right guys on the ice defensively. A guy like Brooks Orpik.
Could a whole season be down to one faceoff? Zetterberg and Staal to go for it with 6.5 to go. The tie-up. It comes back to the point. Rafalski, the shot. Knocked down his left. Scramble. The shot. And the shot. The horn sounds and the Penguins have won the Stanley
games to finish the season. They went from 10th place out of the playoffs to 4th. And then in the postseason, 16 wins out of 24, knocking out the defending champions. And the question that was above Marc-Andre Fleury the last time in here in Detroit answered with two marvelous plays late. Just as Chris Osgood had made some strong plays late a year ago in Pittsburgh. The Penguins continue to celebrate, and now they peel off for the traditional handshake. And Marian Hossa, who took the gamble to come to Detroit thinking he could win a championship this year, came just a goal short.
Thank you.
Smythe Trophy for the most valuable player here shortly.
Hockey League champions.
The games, it comes to about 230 preseason, regular season, postseason for the two teams combined to get down to one.
The Pittsburgh Penguins, Doc, they got it done on the road in the Stanley Cup playoffs. They clinched a series against the Flyers in Philadelphia. They beat the Washington Capitals in seven games in Washington. They sweep the Carolina Hurricanes in Raleigh in four games, and then in game seven against the Detroit Red Wings.
Mike Babcock in 2003 in Anaheim coached Dan Bylsma, one of his players. They lost in seven to New Jersey. He stayed out to watch the celebration. He got to take part in one a year ago in Pittsburgh, and now he watches as his former player gets to be a part of one here in Detroit.
Played great. Enjoyed it. That's great leadership by you, Mike.
And you were able to overhear that conversation between the coach of the Red Wings and the captain of the Penguins. But it said on those t-shirts, the pen's in your hand. What a story they've written. Dan Bylsma arrived and said, the sports writers will write it, but you really will write the story for them. It'll be quite a story in Pittsburgh and all around hockey tomorrow. We'll get the announcement of the most valuable player. Henrik Zetterberg was accorded that honor a year ago. Who will it be this year? We will learn in just seconds.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the ice. The presentation of the Conn Smythe Trophy to the 2009 Stanley Cup Playoffs Most Valuable Player.
Let's congratulate two terrific teams on a great Stanley Cup final, the Pittsburgh Penguins and the Detroit Red Wings. The winner of the Conn Smythe Trophy is Evgeny Malkin.
Evgeny Malkin is the first player since Mario Lemieux in 1991-92 to win the Art Ross Trophy and the Conn Smythe Trophy and to be the leading point getter in the playoffs as well.
Two power play goals in the Stanley Cup final. But I thought he won that award if the Penguins would win the Stanley Cup, Doc. The way he played defensively in Game 6 swayed that trophy to Evgeny Malkin. And what a difference a year makes. Last year, he just seemed like he ran out of gas. Was really invisible in the Stanley Cup finals this year. In all ends.
As there was a netminder scramble around Chris Osgood at the end last year, there was one dangerous set of plays around Marc-Andre Fleury this year. So Evgeny Malkin celebrates with his teammates. Jordan Staal was called the X Factor, the important player on the team by Dan Bylsma this morning. He's pretty happy, why wouldn't he be? And a strong performance here, as he did have in Game 6, and he called him the best player in Game 5 in a losing cause, 5-0.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Stanley Cup.
It takes a great champion to beat a great champion. Congratulations to the Pittsburgh Penguins, General Manager Ray Shiro, Coach Dan Bylsma, and the entire coaching staff. Mario Lemieux and Ron Burkle for saving the Pittsburgh Penguins and bringing them to this championship day. And congratulations to the great fans in Pittsburgh for all of your support. Sidney Crosby, you will be the youngest captain to hoist the Stanley Cup. Congratulations.
You look at the Detroit Red Wings, Doc. Dan Cleary with a bummed up leg. Tomas Holmstrom the same. Chris Draper taking needles just to, in order to play. When you have the opportunity to challenge for that Stanley Cup, you do whatever it takes. And the Penguins are the Stanley Cup champions.
Pierre and Sid.
Well, Sidney, 4 years in the league, you've done just about everything. You're now at the top of the mountain. What's the view like?
It's unbelievable. I mean, it's the stuff you dream about as a kid, and it's reality now. And you know, it's we work so hard. We've been through so much this season, and it's amazing to see how far we've come. And couldn't feel any better.
When the coaching change was made, you guys were not in the playoffs. When did you know that you had a legitimate chance to win the cup?
Well, I don't think until we got in the playoffs. You know, we were battling so hard to get ourselves just in the playoff picture. But, you know, once we got by Philly and, you know, we felt pretty confident against Washington. And, you know, we just seemed to pick up momentum as the playoffs went on. And it was a great series. It was tough. But, you know, we thought we were tested all along the way. And, you know, we came up big here. Guys played great.
You got injured in the second period. Obviously, there was a question as to whether you would play in the third. Did you stand and say anything to the players before you came out for the third period?
No, just wanted to keep doing what they were doing. I mean, you know, we did a pretty good job of keeping things, you know, away from Flower, and he was doing a good job of making the saves when he needed to. But, you know, Max came up with some big goals there, and, you know, we just wanted to play the same way. But it's not easy watching, especially this time here.
What do you want to say to the people back in Pittsburgh?
Oh, thank you so much. I mean, you know, we had a tough start this season. They stuck behind us. They've been so loyal to us for a long time, and, you know, they deserve this. So we're really happy to bring it back there.
Congratulations. You're part of an amazing Pittsburgh Penguin legacy. You deserve this.
Thank you very much.
Doc and Edzo.
Just noticed Marc-Andre Fleury overcoming a couple of embarrassing goals in the early part of this series, but it is how you finish, and he finished strong.
Doc, the true colors of someone or some team are not when things are great, but when things are tough. And I think Marc-Andre Fleury certainly showed what he was made of under the adversity of getting pulled in Game 5, bouncing back making some great stops in game six, that late save. You talk about Stanley Cup winning saves, Doc. That happened 60 minutes ago in the world of the National Hockey League. The stop on Dan Cleary to keep it a 2-1 Penguin lead. But to me, Marc-Andre Fleury is an elite goaltender and made an unbelievable stop at the end of the game to give the Penguins the Stanley Cup championship.
Can't imagine how he can put his thoughts into words, but he's with Pierre.
Marc-Andre Fleury, your folks' coach as a professional was Eddie Olchuk. He just said your save at the end of the third period was spectacular. Take us through that save.
I knew there wasn't much time left. The rebound was wide, and I saw it start coming into it. So I know I just tried to get my body out there and hit me in the ribs, so that was good.
They started to have a big push at the tail end of the second period, then through most of the third. How did you stabilize things? What was the mode of communication in your own zone?
They're a good team. You know, we're going to give that to them, and they worked hard till the end. And they give us a hard time, you know, to get out of our zone. But the guys, they come composed. We stick to our game plan, and they work out well.
You've had a tough time winning in this building. The last time you won in this building in the playoffs was game five last year in triple overtime. What was your thought process coming in to game seven?
Forget about the first three ones and just start over again in this one. And it's awesome.
The cup weighs 35 pounds. I know you're tired from facing a lot of shots. How heavy is it?
It wasn't too bad. Still not a bad adrenaline, to get that up. So it was fine.
Thanks a lot, Marc-Andre.
Merci beaucoup.
Doc, Enzo.
Saves 22 and 23 were spectacular. Matt Cook and his young son.
Well, you saw Marc-Andre Fleury in control, and you've heard Darren Pang and Mike Milbury talk about it all playoff long and in the Stanley Cup final. Watch the positioning. Watch his left leg. Watch how he pushes, shuffles over, and then in desperation mode, a couple quick little pushes. Nick Lidstrom looking to elevate that puck, knowing how much time was on the clock, Doc. He had to hurry up, but it was almost just leaning and lunging, making himself look big. But Marc-Andre Fleury in control, and what... That was an unbelievable stop as time is coming down in Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Final.
Equipment man Dana Hines handing it over. A guy in Johnstown who was the backup goaltender and equipment man and actually played and made a save in a game there. Mario Lemieux on the ice and Pierre.
Hey, Mario, it never gets old. You did it in 91 and 92. You guys had to make some tough organizational decisions. When did you know this group had it in them?
Well, we knew all along from last year going down to the Stanley Cup Finals. But anytime you have Sid on your team and Malkin and Fleury and Staal, and you can go down the line, I think you have a chance to be successful. We had a tough year this year, but made some changes. Started to play better towards the end of the year. We had a great run. So, again, when you have Sid on your team, anything's possible.
You told me after game five you guys got beat pretty handily here that you would be back and you would be fine. What was your message? Because I understand you gave a message to the team before game six. How did you stabilize the situation?
No, just that we stick together. We win as a team. We lose as a team. And, I just told the guys that we're going back to Pittsburgh. We're going to win game six and win the cup here on Friday, which we did. So it's a great night for all of our fans back home and the organization, the players. I'm proud for the players, and they've worked their whole life to make it happen, and especially for Sid and Malkin. I mean, these kids are unbelievable, so I'm very happy for them.
Sidney Crosby is your tenant. Will he be your tenant next year? And what do you tell him at the dinner table?
No, I told him that he can stay as long as he wants. He's 21 years old. What is he going to do by himself? He can buy a big house. He can do all that stuff. But I think the most important part for him is to have a family atmosphere, which he has with our kids. And that's all that matters. So he can stay as long as he wants.
Thanks a lot, Mario. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Way to go.
Appreciate it. Thanks.
Max Talbot with a couple, including the winner.
His seventh and eighth goal in a Stanley Cup Final Game 7. Let's go to ice level here with Maxime Talbot.
Max, two goals tonight. Sidney Crosby out. Things don't look good. They're getting a big push. What'd you say in the third period before you came out?
Yeah, I'm not going to lie. We're trying to hold on. Obviously, we're saying we need to put pressure.
We're applauding for Mario Lemieux, his own McCut.
It's unbelievable.
And good for the Detroit Red Wing fans to acknowledge this. Outstanding by the fans here in Detroit.
It was a real nice. guys in the room. He pushed us. He wrote a note for us before the game seven. He's an unbelievable guy, and he's the winner once again.
So he wins. Now it's his third cup. This is your first cup. What about next year? You got a lot of young legs here. You don't have a lot of free agency problems. Can you guys come back and get here again?
Well, we're going to enjoy this first before we think about next year, but I think we have a great core guy. You know, we got a great group, and who knows? You know, we can do it again next year, but we're just trying to enjoy that.
You're the guy that stabilizes Marc-Andre Fleury. What did you do?
I got to get in the picture.
Okay, you got
Marc-Andre. Great goal.
He loves Marc-Andre Fleury. Great goalie, and he taught Rob Scudori how to play goaltender for game number six, and that's why we had a game seven. Doc and Edzo.
The celebration goes on here in Detroit. And the age-old Stanley Cup will have all of these names. If you play a game in the final or 40 in the regular season, automatically your name is one of the 52. That is the limit, 52, that will be on. Mario Lemieux will have his name on for the third time, though not as a player this time. My, this has been something. Began on January 1st at Wrigley Field and now finishes up at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Named for a prize fighter, with a prize fighter named Ali on hand to watch it. Terrific spectacles all year, and the best spectacle of all was the effort that the players left from round one to round four and the last two saves by Marc-Andre Fleury. Thursday, Tiger Woods begins the defense of his U.S. Open title. From the renowned black course of Bethpage, it's the 109th U.S. Open. Our coverage begins at 3 p.m. Eastern here on NBC. And Roger Federer looks to become the all-time leader in Grand Slam titles. The Championships Wimbledon coming June 27th, both a part of NBC Sports Championship season. Tonight, following your late local news, it's The Tonight Show with Conan O'Brien. Conan's guests are Jamie Foxx and Kevin Nealon. That's tonight on NBC. For Mike Milbury, Pierre McGuire, Darren Pang, and Eddie Olczyk, the Pittsburgh Penguins are the NHL's Stanley Cup champions. From Detroit, Mike Emmerich saying, good night all.